everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be finding the equation of the tangent line to the parametric curve that's defined by x equals 2t squared plus 1 and y equals 3t cubed plus 2. They've asked us to find the equation of the tangent line at the point t equals 1. Remember that t is the parameter in this equation. That's what makes it a parametric curve. T is the parameter. We've been asked to find the equation of the tangent line at the point t equals 1. And I've gone ahead and written the formula for the tangent line over here. Notice that we need to find two pieces of information. One is the slope of the tangent line, which is m, and the other is a point on the graph, which is at the coordinate point x1, y1. So in order to find x1, y1, all we need to do is plug t equals 1 into our equations for x and y, and we'll get a coordinate point, x sub 1, y sub 1. So if we plug t in, or we plug 1 in for t into these equations for x and y, we'll get x equals 2 times 1 squared plus 1, and we'll find that x is equal to 3. If we plug 1 in for t into our equation for y, we'll get y equals 3 times 1 cubed plus 2, and we'll find that y is equal to 5. So our coordinate point is going to be 3, 5, and we can plug that in for x sub 1, y sub 1. Now, if we want to find the slope, m, remember that the tangent line is, or if we want to find the slope of the tangent line, we just need to take the derivative of the curve, dy over dx. So normally the derivative, right, is dy over dx. In this case, since we have parametric equations, we're going to put the derivative of y in the numerator and the derivative of x in the denominator. So we'll first take the derivative of 3t cubed plus 2, and we'll get 9t squared. So that means that dy is 9t squared, so we put that in our numerator. Then the derivative of x, 2t squared plus 1, is 4t. So dx is equal to 4t, so that goes in our denominator. So we found dy dx, which would normally be the derivative of our equation y of x if we didn't have the parameter in here. So this is just our shortcut for doing it with the parameter. We haven't yet eliminated the parameter. We've still got t's involved here. But notice that now we can cancel some t's from both the numerator and denominator. We'll end up with just 9t over 4. And in order to completely eliminate the parameter, we need to just plug in 1 for t, since we've been asked to find the equation of the tangent line at this point. So we'll get 9 times 1 over 4, which is just going to give us 9/4. And that is the slope of our tangent line, m. So we're going to say that's equal to m. So basically, normally you would have an equation y of x, right, equals something in terms of x, and you would find the derivative y prime of x, plug in your point, x equals 1 or whatever, and that would give you your slope m. In this case, since we have parametric equations, we take the derivative of the parametric equation for y, put that in the numerator, then the parametric equation for x, put that in the denominator, simplify, plug in our point, t equals 1, and that's the way that we find the slope m. So now that we've got m and we've got our coordinate point 3, 5, we can go ahead and find the equation of the tangent line. So we'll say y minus 5, right? This is coming in here. Y minus 5 equals, we found that the slope was 9/4, and then we'll do x minus 3, which this is going to come in over here, x minus 3. So we could leave our equation of the tangent line in this form, but it's probably best to simplify. So we'll get y minus 5 equals 9/4 x minus 27 over 4. We'll multiply through both sides by 4 to get 4y minus 20 equals 9x minus 27. And then let's go ahead and move the negative 20 to the right-hand side. We'll end up with 4y equals 9x. Adding 20 to both sides gives us a negative 7 over here on the right. And then we can leave our equation like this, but I'm going to go ahead and just divide by 4 to get this into slope-intercept form. So we'll end up with y equals 9 fourths x minus 7 fourths, and that's the equation of our tangent line in slope-intercept form. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!